Hello students, today we will discuss how to apply Bernoulli's equation. Yes, application of Bernoulli's equation. Bernoulli's equation is applied in all problems of incompressible fluid flow where energy consideration are involved. First example, now suppose this is the tank and this is pipe which is connected to the tank, and head of fluid, this is free surface, this is the fluid, and fluid flow through this pipe, and this is the exit point where velocity of this fluid, suppose the point 2, the velocity is v2. And head of this fluid, this is equal to h, means head h, this remains constant, assuming the head remains constant. Now consider point 1 and point 2. Let point 1, it is on a streamline, this is point 1, this is the path of this fluid particle. We can consider point 1 here, and the path of this fluid particle, means this is a streamline, it may be here, these are the path of fluid particle or streamlines. Now point 1 may be at the free surface or at this point. So consider point 1 and point 2, and assuming the losses equal to 0. In this example, we consider the losses in the pipe, it equal to 0. Now applying Bernoulli's equation between point 1 and 2. Now at point 1, the pressure is P1, then pressure head P1 upon rho g plus kinetic head V1 square upon 2g plus Z1 equal to P2 upon rho g plus V2 square upon 2g plus Z2, and losses in this problem means H equal to 0. Now P1, where P1 equal to outside pressure, this is P atmospheric, means pressure outside this, P atmospheric pressure. Now P1 equal to atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to head rho gh, and velocity at this point, velocity v1, this is approximately 0, then v1 equal to 0 and z1 equal to z2 because it is horizontal, and p2 equal to p atmospheric. Now p atmospheric plus rho gh upon rho g plus v1 square means 0 square upon 2g plus z1 equal to p atmospheric upon rho g plus v2 square upon 2g plus z2 equal to z1 plus the losses in the pipe is 0. Now p atmospheric divided by rho g plus rho g h upon rho g plus 0, z1 cancel out, equal to p atmospheric by rho g plus v2 square upon 2g. Now p atmospheric and p atmospheric by rho g, it is cancel out, and rho g cancel out, then h equal to v2 square by 2g. R, velocity of fluid at the exit of pipe, v2 equal to 2g into h meter per second if h in meter. The velocity of fluid at the exit of pipe, velocity of fluid at exit of pipe, v2 equal to under root 2gh meter per second, assuming the losses in pipe h equal to 0. So this is the velocity at the exit of pipe, and flow through pipe q equal to area of pipe multiply by velocity v. Then at the exit, the velocity of fluid at the exit of pipe is v2, and area of pipe at exit a2, then a2 into under root 2gh. The flow through pipe means theoretical discharge, this is equal to a2 into under root 2gh meter cube per second. If we consider the losses which is not equal to 0, suppose this is equal to h losses, then applying Bernoulli's equation. Now second example, if losses, consider losses which is equal to h losses, then applying Bernoulli's equation between point 1 and 2. Now between point 1 and 2, p1 by rho g plus v1 square upon 2g plus z1 equal to p2 upon rho g plus v2 square upon 2g plus z2 plus losses. Now substituting same value, we will get H equal to V2 square by 2G plus H losses. Means like this. H equal to V2 square by 2G. Here due to losses, H equal to V2 square by 2G plus H losses R V2 square upon 2G equal to H minus H losses. Then velocity at exit of pipe considering losses, then V2 equal to under root 2G H equal to head minus H this is the velocity at the exit of pipe and flow through pipe or discharge Q equal to A2 into V2, then Q equal to A2 into under root 2G H minus H losses. This is the discharge through pipe, consider the losses. Now example 3. Flow through orifice flow through hole. Suppose this is the tank. And this is the hole, and this is head, this is fluid, now the hole may be in the side of tank. This is the tank. Here, this is here. This is the this is fluid of head H. In first case, the hole at the bottom, and in second case, in B, the hole is side of the tank. Now consider the two points, point 1 and point 2. Point 2, it is at the exit of the hole, means this is the point 2. Here exit of the hole is this is 2. Now point 1, suppose this is a fluid, the path of this fluid particle, this is the fluid particle, path of fluid particle like this, these are the path of fluid particle. Now consider this is point 1. Similarly, in hole, this is fluid particle, path of fluid particle, mean these are the streamlines. Now consider, this is point 1. Now assuming the losses is equal to 0 and applying Bernoulli's equation between point 1 and 2. Now this H, it should be constant, means the head edge, it is constant, means now applying Bernoulli's equation between point 1 and 2, then at point 1 pressure head P1 upon rho g plus V1 square upon 2g plus Z1 equal to P2 upon rho g plus V2 square upon 2g plus Z2. At pressure at point 1, P1 equal to P atmospheric V1, this is approximately equal to 0, and Z1 minus Z2, this is equal to H, the difference between Z1 and Z2, this is H, and pressure at the exit of hole P2 upon rho g, this is equal to P atmospheric, and we have to find out velocity V2. Now substituting P1, V1, P2, V2 in above equation, then P atmospheric upon rho g plus 0 square upon 2g plus Z1 minus Z2, this is equal to H equal to P2 upon rho g, P atmospheric plus V2 square upon 2g. P atmospheric upon rho g. Now P atmospheric upon rho g and P atmospheric upon rho g cancel out, and V 0 square upon 2g, it is 0. Then H equal to V2 square upon 2g. Then the velocity at the exit of pipe, V2 equal to under root 2g H. So this is theoretical velocity, and actual velocity, which is less than this V2, actual velocity V actual, which is less than under root 2g H, then we apply a coefficient of velocity. This is coefficient of, for actual velocity we use coefficient of velocity, which is less than the value of coefficient of velocity, it is less than 1. And discharge through hole, discharge through hole or orifice, Q equal to area of orifice or hole multiplied by velocity वी टू. तो दिस इज थियोरटिकल वेलोसिटी और थियोरटिकल डिस्चार्ज. दिस इज थियोरटिकल वेलोसिटी. देन क्यू थियोरटिकल इक्वल टू ए इंटू एरिया ऑफ ऑरिफिस, एरिया ऑफ होल आर ऑरिफिस. दिस इज इक्वल टू ए इंटू अंडर रूट टू जी एच. तो दिस इज द डिस्चार्ज थ्रू ऑरिफिस एंड थियोरटिकल डिस्चार्ज. दिस इज इक्वल टू ए इंटू अंडर रूट टू जी एच. दिस इज मल्टीप्लाई बाय कोफिशियंट ऑफ डिस्चार्ज. द वैल्यू ऑफ थियोरटिकल डिस्चार्ज इट इज लेस देन, सॉरी, एक्चुअल डिस्चार्ज इट इज लेस देन थियोरटिकल डिस्चार्ज. एंड दिस इज कोफिशियंट ऑफ डिस्चार्ज. देन डिस्चार्ज थ्रू ऑरिफिस, देन एक्चुअल डिस्चार्ज, दिस इज इक्वल टू सी डी इंटू एरिया ऑफ ऑरिफिस मल्टीप्लाई बाय टू जी एच. एंड वेलोसिटी इज सी वी इंटू अंडर रूट टू जी एच. देन सी डी कोफिशिएंट ऑफ डिस्चार्ज इक्वल टू क्यू थियोरटिकल डिस्चार्ज अपॉन एक्चुअल डिस्चार्ज. सॉरी, एक्चुअल डिस्चार्ज अपॉन थियोरटिकल डिस्चार्ज. एंड कोफिशिएंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी, दिस इज इक्वल टू एक्चुअल वेलोसिटी अपॉन थियोरटिकल वेलोसिटी. नाउ एट द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ ऑरिफिस आर होल, if we enlarge it, diagram, we make this diagram at bottom. If we enlarge this orifice, this is sharp edge orifice. This is the orifice. On this side, this is the fluid. And path of fluid particle at the surface, it is like this. These are the path of fluid particles. So this is orifice. The area of this orifice is area of orifice. This is A. And area at this point, are at this section, which is less than, this is A, C. Here the area of jet, area of this jet, this is equal to AC. This AC, this is less than orifice area A. Now, at the minimum cross-sectional area of this jet, this is converging and then diverging. This portion is converging portion and this is diverging portion, and here the area is minimum area of jet. Here this is minimum. Now at this point where area is maximum or minimum, here the streamlines are parallel. First condition of this cross section is the minimum cross section. Second, the streamlines are parallel, and the third, now pressure inside this tank is higher than atmospheric pressure. Now here the velocity it is increasing, and at this point the velocity it is maximum, means velocity it is maximum, and the fourth point, at this point the pressure P, this is equal to P atmospheric. So this cross section or this area, it is known vena contracta. At vena contracta, the area, cross section area of jet is minimum, streamlines are parallel, velocity is maximum, and pressure is atmospheric pressure, and coefficient of vena contracta, coefficient of vena contracta, this is equal to area at vena contracta, AC divided by orifice area. This is area of orifice and this is the area of vena contracta. Suppose the diameter at diameter of jet at vena contracta, suppose this is equal to DC, then coefficient of vena contracta, this is equal to pi by 4 DC square upon pi by 4 D square, or this is equal to DC square upon D square, or CC equal to this is the coefficient of vena contracta, and the relation between CD, CV and CC, this is CD equal to coefficient of discharge equal to CV into CC. This is the relation between coefficient of discharge, coefficient of velocity and coefficient of vena contracta. Next example. Now, this is the tank. Now, this is pipe connected to this tank. And this is the free surface of fluid. Now, this is a small pipe, and the angle of this pipe, this is alpha, and the head, this is equal to H. Now, this is the exit of this pipe. The velocity of fluid particle at the exit of this pipe is under root 2gh. Then, this is the jet, free liquid jet. The free liquid jet is defined as the jet of fluid coming out from the nozzle in atmosphere. Means this is the free jet. This is the free jet. This is the jet. The angle of this pipe, the initial angle is suppose alpha. And horizontal distance, this is x-axis and this is y-axis. Now, the velocity at the exit of pipe, this is in this direction. Suppose this is u at angle alpha. Now, this is the path of jet. Let this is range R. And this is origin. The coordinate of this origin is 0, 0, 0. And let at this point, at point P, the coordinate is xy, means this is x and this is y. Now, at this point, the velocity, this is equal to V, and angle at this point, it is theta with x. Now, you having two component, one is in horizontal direction, which is equal to velocity of u in horizontal direction, u cos alpha, and in y direction, u sin alpha. Similarly, velocity component of v in horizontal direction, v cos theta, and this is v sin theta. the maximum height, suppose this is equal to h. Now, equation of motion in equations of motion in horizontal direction and in vertical direction. Now, the first equation in horizontal direction, v cos theta equal to u cos alpha plus 0 into t, because the g, this is in this direction and acceleration in horizontal direction, this is equal to 0, then v cos theta equal to u cos alpha, equation 1. Second, x equal to u cos alpha t plus 1 upon 2 gt square, this is equal to 0, then this is second equation, and v cos theta square equal to u cos alpha square plus 0, means equation 1 and 2, this is 0. Here we have applied v equal to u plus at, s equal to ut plus half at square, here v square equal to u square plus 2as. In first case, or in horizontal direction, a equal to 0, then v, what is v? V, it is horizontal component of velocity, so v cos theta equal to u cos alpha. Second, x equal to, means horizontal component equal to u cos alpha into t. Third, v cos theta square equal to u cos alpha square. Then equation 1 and 2, it is same. Then we delete it. Now, applying in vertical direction, v sin theta equal to u sin alpha minus g into t, this is equation 3, and y equal to u sin alpha t minus 1 upon 2 g t square, this is equation 4, and v sin theta whole square equal to u sin whole square minus 2as, a is g and s is y. So there are five equations, equation 1 and 2, this is for horizontal direction, and equation 3, 4, 5, it is in vertical direction. Now, if we eliminate R from equation, from equation 2 and 4, R eliminate, T eliminate T from equation 2 and 4, then x equal to, y equal to u sin alpha and t equal to x upon u cos alpha minus 1 upon 2 g t square. T square means x upon u cos alpha whole square, then y equal to x, u cancel out, x tan alpha minus g x square upon 2 u square cos square alpha. So this is the equation of path of jet. This is the path of jet. Now, for maximum height, at maximum height, this is the maximum height. In maximum height, the horizontal component, it becomes zero at maximum height. For maximum height, horizontal component, it becomes zero. Now using equation 5, then zero square equal to u sin alpha whole square minus 2g into h, then h equal to then maximum height, this is equal to u square sine square alpha upon 2g, this is h. And for the range R, at maximum height, the range here, this is R by 2. Then we can calculate from above equations. From equation 1, 2, 3 and 4, we can calculate every parameters like velocity, angle, time, coordinates, all these parameters can be calculated. Okay.